Why did Quicken secure a loan with a house that was already mortgaged? Did Brian and Deborah Chiesi know that their deed was the fruit of the poison tree? Both recorded claims against the title of Bruce's house in December 2019, 4 months after Nona filed a lawsuit in Judge Johnson's court. The Brian and Deborah Chiesi share the same attorney with Quicken Loans. Both have adverse claims against Nona recorded during the litigation. Both allegedly have title insurance issued by Driggs Title to cover any losses. Why are they siding with people who Nona says defrauded her? Quicken's and Chiesi's attorney Brittany Wood has demanded that Nona pay $9,709 to her for attorney fees for being forced to defend against Nona's complaint that they say was frivolous. Was it frivolous to complain that Joel Stokes had no right to sell a house Nona says is hers? Or to say that Quicken should know better than give a loan for a house already encumbered by two mortgages? Was it frivolous for Nona to file a complaint for quiet title a week before the 5-year statute of limitations after ex-party misrepresentations to Judge Kishner caused her to lose her rights to make a claim in that court or the appellate courts? How was it better for Quicken and Chiesi to ignore two Lee pendants, two disputed mortgages and two disputed deeds to join with the parties Nona is accusing of criminal fraud? Why join a motion to dismiss Nona's claims to the $57,282 undistributed proceeds when Quicken and Chiesi have no interest in the sale proceeds? Why argue that the proceeds of the sale belong to NationStar and not to Nona and then say Nona has no right to be heard? Why should Nona pay attorney fees to an attorney who was either incompetent in her review of the official Clark County property records, or was disingenuous in her selective exclusion of critical disputed records from her lengthy and expensive request for judicial notice? Brittany Wood's clients were not parties to the prior litigation, nor was Joel Stokes, the individual who sold them the property. So, what was the point of claiming that the parties were the same because they were in privity with each other by the sale? Brittany Wood's filing shows that she was well aware that Jimajack's deed was inadmissible as evidence pursuant to NRS 111.345. Why then falsely claim that Nona had a wild deed? Nona's authority to close the Gordon B. Hansen Trust and execute a deed to transfer its sole asset to the sole remaining beneficiary has been uncontradicted in the Clark County official property record since 2017. Why would Attorney Wood push the preposterous argument that Nona was in privity with herself as trustee of a trust that was closed in 2017 while ignoring Jimajack's obviously defective deed? Is it because they knew that the Chiesi deed is the fruit of the poison tree? Why else would they condone the covert transfer of Jimajack's defective deed to non-party Joel A. Stokes before the trial?
Court realizing that they didn't have any evidence.
Give them a show that's so splendiferous, row after row, row vociferous, give them the old.